But we have one more player, one more match to go through here in the first round of the loser's side, and that will be between Itazan and Daigo Umehara.
Ooh-wee, this is going to be great, because we have Daigo, who we've seen, we all know and have tracked his progress, for those that are fans. Of course, a lot of the folks in the FGC are pretty much fans of Daigo. You guys have been seeing him grind it day in, day out on his stream, right? Very standard. He's like, you know what, I'm going to do the most meticulous things and make sure this is like the most effective way I could use this like to enhance my performance. Right? But you have Itabashi Zangief as well, who's just kind of like, I have the most unconventional playstyle sometimes, and I'm more read-based, if anything. But no, I mean, I'm not trying to take away any credit from Itabashi. He does have the right reads as well, but it's all those situations where he puts those opponents in those state of minds where he's like, all right, well, they have to guess, and I know exactly how they're going to react in this situation. So it's going to be very interesting to see the meticulous work that Daigo's put in versus someone like Itabashi, who plays more of the mental.
Right. Yeah, and you know, Daigo, as you mentioned, been streaming so much, showing everything. I think the most important thing that we've seen on his stream is that he has the cat cam all the time on his stream.
Actually,
definitely the most important thing. But let's take a see what the players have to say. Here you can see top eight. Let's go. I can do this.
I believe.
CPT is intense.
It is.
CPT is intense.
What a turnaround, right? Because he knew his situation in top 16, in, you know, where he was at on the loser's side, but you know, he's changed his attitude.
Okay.
But we want to see what Daigo has to say. Mm-hmm. It better be more than a yes. Okay.
We always have difficult matches, but I will do my best to play well.
Without a doubt in my mind, both of these players will be doing that as we get ourselves ready for the match. We took a look at Daigo's run as well. We saw where Itabashi ended up in losers. We saw that he was sent down there by John Takauchi.
Yes.
But Daigo was actually sent to losers relatively early in pools, and a lot of folks were covering that on Twitter. They were saying that, you know, Daigo was sent to losers by a Vega player named Jimmy One.
Jimmy One won one?
Yeah, he definitely did against Daigo. The one to win it on, too.
Nice. And you mean, again, just these Vega players, you know, they can't downplay their character anymore. All right, he's good. We've been exposing you since last season, since last year, you know. Vega definitely. I mean, but again, you know, I talked about it yesterday, just the wonderful job that the Capcom balance team has been doing with the game. I really feel like the game is in this really wonderful state where you have a giant variety of 40-plus characters that can all do very different things. And, you know, obviously some are still a little bit on the weaker side, some are a little bit on the stronger side. But, I mean, look, as an old man, this balance is amazing compared to some of the things that we've had to deal with in the best CVS1, Nako.
That side of the table. Oh, I haven't been around long enough.
Oh, he's going with Zangief. I really wasn't expecting this, actually. I thought he was going to go with Abigail. He's going with the Zangief. Okay.
And I like it because you get to use that flex in turn with the V-Shift, right? Now that exists, it makes it a lot harder for Guile to get away with certain Sonic moves, right? So I think this is a great combination for Itabashi Zangief, and I say that, but he's at a huge life deficit against Daigo.
Yep, Daigo is just getting the little damage here and there just from Sonic Booms and from little pokes here. But, oh, God. Here he goes. Got him. EX Air SPD. Yep. So he goes. Mix up.
And look at the equalizer.
Yep, the regular throw. Oh, but he knows that dashing after the regular throw is not a real thing.
And this is a tough situation. But, you know, Daigo does have the cuffs at the bottom.
Yeah.
He's got the cuffed boots. Or excuse me, cuffed military cargo pants.
God, that was also a world. Oh, he knew he was going for the air to air. You are a sick man, Itabashi.
Oh, remember what we prefaced this with, James? This man has the right reads, and Daigo learned his lesson the first time. He's like, you know, I got this. Medium kick, no problem.
Guile has gone from the Air Force to the Army now. Stay grounded here. But, man, he is
Air
using...
Air Force to the Marines, like, I guess, like infantry, probably.
He it's really interesting to me that Daigo is using a very classic Guile style here. The moves that he's using to anti-air and to stop the opponent jumping feels very World Warriors.
Yeah, that's a fair assessment.
All right. Ooh. There we go. There's that stand medium kick again.
Again, we haven't really seen Itabashi do relatively well in this neutral phase, mm-hmm. right, where Daigo is just chucking out a lot of booms. Mm. A lot of V-skills were happening, but...
Oh, Daigo just missed the jump attack. He had the right counter there. He knows you can jump in that activation situation. He just missed the jump attack.
Oh, boy. You know Itabashi's getting closer and closer. He's going back a little bit, but he's taking more steps forward than he's going back. Right? He wants to get in that comfortable range to possibly SPD.
Daigo was just not scared of the walk-up SPD at all. He just stayed blocking that whole time.
Itabashi is using that jab to kind of measure himself too, right? Using that as a counter poke as well as a measuring tool.
Ooh, trade. Oh, God. Oh, Daigo is just no fear. He's just not scared.
You know, you're going to eat an EX SPD soon.
He's got to! Oh. But Itabashi,
who's scared of who, James? Who is scared of who? Who is the monster here? I cannot tell. The man, the big scary man wearing an animal on his back? Or is it the guy with the flattest of tops?
And no eyebrows.
And no eyebrows.
I can't believe Itabashi did not try to go for an EX SPD, and Daigo knew that whole time he was willing to sit there. That EX SPD was going to kill him. You know, but Daigo was like, you know what? You're too scared to try to go for this. And let's see if that prompts Itabashi to be a little bit more aggressive with some light SPDs or some EX SPDs in this round.
I like how much more active Itabashi is now with the normals flying about, standing medium punch primarily. But Daigo is still hovering within that range. Oh, big punish. You already know. Oh, a sweep. Still a good punch.
Oh, Daigo. Just so effective in this neutral right here. Oh,
that's fine for Daigo.
Uh-oh. Well, that was a dropped combo by Daigo, and now he's in the blender.
I think it was just too far. Maybe EX flash kick would have been enough, but still, Daigo recovers just fine.
Yeah, no quick rise there.
You're actually dead.
No
You're
quick rise dead. There to not get caught by the meaty V-Trigger 1 activation. And Itabashi did not want to spend another part of that bar on another V-Trigger 1. Went for the jump, and Daigo actually had the anti-air ready to go. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Uh-oh,
yeah.
There you go.
Wake up, EX SPD, reversal time.
For dash up, plus regular throw. Yeah. Oh,
that was a micro step forward, but Daigo was 100% ready for it. Now pushing Itabashi
back
to the corner while Trigger is on deck.
Okay. And he doesn't, I don't think he wants to use the V shift to get himself out of the corner. You mentioned he could V break the Sonic Boom, but it's just not what he's doing. He's building
it. Oh, no, but look at all that gray life. He just got taken out from that stray hit. And is it even worth it at this point to even activate that trigger? Because Daigo, again, 100% ready with the counter.
Mm-hmm. Gets that jump attack and gets the free pressure afterwards. Oh, he was activating because he thought Itazan was going to jump forward, but on that neutral jump, he didn't. Oh, he got him. He got him. Air EX SPD. Okay.
Force dynamite.
One mix
what
up.
Happens after this, though?
Oh, he went for the mix. Oh, Daigo is just ready every single time. He knows all these tricks, and, you know, I was thinking the same thing. He got the EX Air SPD. What does Zangief want to do? He wants to dash up. He's plus frames after that. You got to deal with the mix-up. And so Itazan tried to throw in a little bit of a curveball there. Went for the whiff crouching medium kick in the SPD. Daigo escaping.
You know, there was numerous times where he caught Daigo in those situations, and the follow-up from Itazan wasn't threatening enough for Daigo, right? Mm-hmm. So... he got thrown after an EX Force Dynamite, right?
Right.
Back-to-back times, Daigo was like, I'm going to backdash after this. Yeah. I just took the throw. I'm totally fine after this, I feel like.
Yeah. Daigo, I mean, honestly, the mix-up from Itabashi, like I said.
Oh, yeah.
That
now
was a great
make
reaction.
Make it hurt afterwards.
Okay. Can't jump away. Oh, he went for it again.
Yes, he can. Okay, yes, so he can after.
He's out of the corner. Oh, here we go. Yep. The pressure. Another again, one more mix-up. Oh, God, what do you got to do? Yeah.
You're going to keep him locked down. You're going to keep him locked down, and that's an excellent choice to use the meter as well to kind of freeze time and get yourself that advantage to, you know, execute either a throw, a frame trap, what have you, because Itabashi was just in that circumstance to not be able to take the throw.
And it was just nice because, you know, he was one hit away from stun, so Daigo used that V-trigger activation to set up the mix-up.
Ooh.
I think Itazan was expecting high or low, but then Daigo went for throw. Oh, God, we saw him do that yesterday against Poison.
Beautifully done.
Yeah. Oh, no, and he still gets away in time.
And I love that. Using the target combo into the V-skill too. So much damage and the corner carry as well.
Yeah, just push him away. Guile just does not want to get walked to the corner. And we have not seen a walk-up SPD from Itazan at all. Mm-hmm. And Daigo is walking into the range, and Itazan is getting caught off guard by it, it feels like.
I think he's trying to catch Itabashi slipping and go into V-trigger. Right. He wants to force that activation.
Oh, here
we
go.
He gets it off of a hit instead.
It's going to be a combo into the super. Not going to kill, but going to be very close.
And yet, his hair is still intact.
Okay, got him. You know, he was expecting Daigo to probably try to backdash again or something. So throws in the meaty and catches Guile before he can get airborne. Gets the punish there.
That was a very valid concern, right?
Oh, no! Oh, boy, that is a painful misstep from Daigo right there. A lot of that meter gone. Itazan now trying to find his way in.
But do you think that's a green light for Itabashi to go in? I feel like for Daigo, it's like, no big deal.
It feels like it because you see Itazan jumping a little bit more often and a couple of anti-airs now from Daigo. I feel like Itazan almost kind of got baited into thinking he could push a little bit harder.
Yeah, and I totally understand that. But here comes Daigo again. Still has so much bar already whilst maintaining the life lead. This guy has been keeping Itabashi suppressed.
Oh, did he get him?
A slight error.
Okay, here we go. So he has been unsuccessful in his mix-up before. What's the mix-up now? Okay!
Just do it again. Do it one more time. Heavy SPD.
No. Oh. Go! And Daigo with the stubborn backdashes gets himself out of there. He tried to use the range on the light SPD! Itazan on the board with the empty jump in the SPD. I love it. Let's go, Itazan.
I like that a lot. That was beautiful done. That was beautiful done. It's exactly what we needed to see from Itabashi. He needs to take a little bit more risk going for that SPD. You saw nothing, James. But yeah, again, the threat of that SPD immediately after the first one needs to be applied.
Yeah.
It needs to be applied.
And it was that's got to make Itazan feel good because Daigo so far has had the right reads on all of Itazan's mix-ups. And for Itazan to get that closing sequence, to get the double back-to-back EX SPDs, then kind of the hits into the empty jump SPD is really important sign for Itazan that he's gotten Daigo a little more flummoxed.
You see here again, Itabashi Zangief now pushing Daigo pretty early this time around into this corner. However, Daigo has maintained the life so well.
That SPD was a whiff punish SPD. Too far away for that to be a meaty.
Lost the V-trigger. He's going to try to push the agenda a little bit. Oh, that sharp angle. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The sharp angle that catches the startup of the Lariat.
Yeah. Can't hit on the other side. Not the old school Lariat anti-air of old. Oh, God. What is Daigo doing?
He can't throw a boom, but the EX one catches Itabashi off guard.
Mm-hmm. Ooh! Too far away to do anything after that headbutt.
He still can't throw a boom.
God.
Not safely, at least.
Ooh! Oh, nice! Patience to Daigo. He got him. Okay, he had that V-trigger still going over there.
Yeah.
He still has
absolutely.
It. And again, Itabashi still, to this point, has not been brave enough to just do a walk-up raw EX SPD. He has not been willing to do that yet. I'm not sure what's holding him back from that.
Sonic booms and normals.
Okay, fair. Fair. Okay, he's got the Lariat. Yep, now he gets the mix-up. V-shift out of there.
Does he get the mix-up? Not in this version.
Throws the V. The V-skill. Oh, God. Trying to find a way. He got him. Okay, here we go.
So much
to stay alive. To stay alive.
He's still going forward. He's like, I dare you to throw a Sonic Boom. I have the V-trigger. Test me right now.
But watch out. We got so much resources on Daigo's body. He's got the activation here.
Sonic Boom going away again. Two bars on the side of Daigo.
Oh.
Oh, my gosh. He's just testing him.
Oh, he got him.
Oh, yes.
Oh, man. All right. Itazan is still in this. He's still in this. It's not over yet, baby.
That's been, it's funny, Itabashi is so set on taking this damage for the meter, or at least the gray life for this meter, he's totally fine with it.
And it's so great because this is the classic Zangief versus Guile strategy. Just keep blocking the Sonic Boons. Block them. Yeah, you're taking all this chip, but you'll find your way in at some point. But Daigo is not letting it happen this round. Tries to get the throw. Oh, here we go.
Right incoming. What's the mix?
Plus, yep. Oh, where are you going?
You thought you could move.
That's the bad lariat. That's the bad lariat, but.
That could have been huge.
Oh, he got him out of the
top. That's one of the buffs. That's one of the buffs. Okay, you can chuck all the booms you want now, Daigo. Yeah, dwindle that gray life. But Itabashi, he's like, yeah, bring that to me too. I'll take that, yeah.
Look at all that gray health. He's got him! The standing heavy kick counter hit. Crush counter. Was that a Sonic Boom that he threw that he hit? I think he hit the Sonic Boom. Itabashi Zangief ties it up 2-2. We have another. This is 3 out of the 4 first round matches going to the last game. Did we not promise you guys some good Street Fighter? I need the Tasty Steve clip here. I need the clip. I dare you to find us better Street Fighter.
You know, I thought this was going to go down as a 3-0 from Lord Daigo. He was looking so strong and poised in those first two games. But Itabashi now switching gears here. Not as Abigail, but as Zangief.
Yeah. And they're so patient. This is not an easy fight at all. Just the patience. But Daigo with the anti-air every single time. And like you said, the knowledge just to have that target combo for the pushback.
Ooh. You see a lot more active throws coming from the side of Daigo. V-reversal out negates that initial V-trigger activation.
But the back throw put
how
him
how many more throws
into the corner. But never mind, gets the second throw. Okay, here we go. Daigo at match point again. Uh-oh. He's just not going to do it.
It's going to come out eventually. It's going to come down to the final.
Right. If Itabashi wins this match but with a walk-up SPD, I'm gonna freak out.
Well, he does get one after a jab attack. Oh, and a slight jiggle, and Daigo was not even going to give it to him. Instead, he's going to give him this critical.
Wow. Well, we saw how fast he built the meter up before last time, so why not? And he's got a V-trigger ready to activate here too as well. Oh, that's going to kill, I think.
Oh, without a doubt, EX Force Dynamite.
Whoa, oh, I lied to you all! V-shift out of there!
I lied to you all.
Oh! Ah!
There is some doubt, but a slight hit, just all he needs, that's all Itabashi needs. Oh, don't get antsy. Don't get antsy. Tie it up. Let me see him some more Street Fighter. Let me see it.
Oh, got him!
Don't do it. Oh, he's still charging.
Oh, he tried to clip him out of the air. Tried to tag him walking backwards, but Daigo staying on
Where's
the ground.
Where's the V-shift, James? Maybe it's not going to reach. I feel like the break maybe is not going to be enough, but still, Itabashi now forces it. Forces it.
Oh! He just kept jamming.
He just did
he
this.
Just
he gave him the platter.
All right. Final game. Final round. Again, third match to go to the final game, final round, and almost all of them with this 0-2 comeback, I feel like.
I love it. Give me more Street Fighter.
Ooh. Oh. Anti-air. Yeah. Has it ready to go. Here we go. Itabashi gets the mix up.
He tried it again. I don't blame him. Look, it's just fine. Although Daigo jumped back, Itabashi did not get a big punish.
Oh!
EX Borsh Dynamite. Here comes another mix.
Daigo's panicking.
In this corner.
Daigo's panicking.
Down. Heavy punch.
He's panicking.
Oh, light SPD.
Okay. What a beautiful walk forward on that one. Did he get him? Oh, yeah. He's going to blow up the armor. That was so smart.
He's going to kill him. And he's eliminated Daigo Umehara.
Itazan with the 0-2 comeback with Zangief. And the most meticulous of play, Itazan eliminates Daigo Umehara from CPT Japan. Last year, Daigo took the first CPT Japan online, but here now, Itazan is the champion. Well, is going to.
Keep it down back there.
Like
we still have so many more games to play.
Thank you guys
Hold
for
it.
Watching.
Hold it. Keep it down. We have more games to play. Chad, don't worry about that. Don't worry about that last statement.
That's how it feels.
The fact of the matter is, Itabashi has eliminated Daigo in a very, very tough set.
Ooh, I can't believe he did it. I mean, it looked like it was going to be just a, 1-2-3-0 match, but Itazan there with the comeback, and there you go. It will be Itabashi Zangief going up against Kawano next.